The Honourable Member for Halifax.
Mr. Speaker, important climate change talks start next week in Durban, and this government can't seem to get its story straight because first they claim to be committed to the environment, but then they muzzle their scientists, and then they're claiming to target redundancies in the system, but we have a senior government official who says there are no redundancies. So we know we're going to be a laughingstock at Durban, because we can't even get the job done at home. So when will the minister realize that he is the Minister of Environment and actually take action on this government's appalling environmental record?
Honourable Minister of the Environment.
Well, Mr. Speaker, I welcome my colleague back from her treacherous adventure abroad. I'm sure Canadian workers and our resource industries will rest much more quietly now that she's back in this place. Mr. Speaker, Canada goes to Durban with a number of countries sharing the same objectives, and that is to put Kyoto behind us and to encourage all nations and all major emitting countries to embrace a new agreement to reduce greenhouse gas reductions in a material way.
The Honourable Member for Halifax.
Mr. Speaker, there is a hole in the ozone above the Arctic that is twice the size of Ontario, and this government's solution is muzzling the scientists who found the hole and slashing the budget of the people who are monitoring it. And this hole is allowing harmful ultraviolet rays into our communities. So this is about protecting our children and our grandchildren. So when will this minister put down his talking points, listen to the scientific community and his own advisors, and become the Minister of Environment? Because it's never too late to learn.
The Honourable Minister of the Environment.
Well, I thank my colleague for those gracious words, Mr. Speaker. And I will reassure her again that my department, Environment Canada, will continue to monitor ozone. And I would remind her in this week when parties to the Montreal Protocol, which was so effective in addressing contaminants in the atmosphere that deplete ozone, that Canada is once again taking a leadership role.
Honourable Member from Rivière des Midi. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. The former Conservative Minister of the Environment stated yesterday that Canada must improve its environmental record on the oil sands. Jim Prentice said so himself. To achieve that will take work and investment. If nothing's done, we risk losing access to markets like Europe and the U.S. When will the government present a plan for the sustainable development of our resources? The Honourable Minister of the Environment.
I think the opposition, and I've said this many times in this House, that the opposition should celebrate Canada as an emerging clean energy superpower. And if I could offer my colleague a quote from the former minister yesterday, he said, I think substantial progress has been made, but I think as events have unfolded both in the United States on Keystone as well as other issues, it highlights how important it is that Canada not only be a producer of clean energy, but an environmentally responsible producer of
energy.
The Honourable Member for Rivière des Mille-Îles. Mr. Speaker, it wasn't a comment made by an environmental crusader. It was the former Conservative Minister of the Environment who's calling for a sustainable plan for developing the oil sands. Yesterday, he said, or on Monday rather, he said that the international perception of Alberta's oil sands was profoundly negative. He added, and I quote, "It's important for Canada not to be seen as a producer of energy, but an environmentally responsible producer of energy." Will the government listen to its former Minister of the Environment? The Honourable Minister of Natural Resources.
As the NDP should know that it's always risky to alienate your political base, but especially when you are in pre-merger discussions. So I will list the labour unions which support Keystone because it will create thousands of jobs. I may run out of time. The General International Union of Operating Engineers, Labour International Union of America, International Brotherhood of Teamsters, International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Building and Construction Trades Department, AFL-CIO, United Association of Journeymen and Apprentices of the Pump Line.
Time. The Honourable Member for Red.